Duchess of Cambridge, showed off her culinary skills today, as she donned an apron to help put the finishing touches to a meal that's being prepared for this year's Commonwealth Big Lunch at St. Luke's Community Centre near Clerkenwell in London. The Big Lunch project aims to encourage as many people as possible to sit down to a meal with members of their community once a year, and pregnant Kate was eager to get stuck in and help with the preparations on her last day of royal duties before maternity leave. This morning, a Kensington Palace spokesperson confirmed today's public engagements by the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge will be Her Royal Highness's last before starting her maternity leave. She may appear at some family occasions during the summer, but is not expected to return to official duties until the autumn, according to aides, and even then her primary focus will be her children. And George and Charlotte were on her mind this morning, as she chatted to guests at St. Luke's, revealing how her children enjoy making pizza dough in the kitchen, saying, "They love that because they can get their hands messy." The royal opted for a smart casual look for her outings today in skinny jeans, teamed with a cream coat by Goat and a non-maternity top from Hobbs. Commonwealth Big Lunch is a part of the official celebrations leading up to the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting, being staged in London and Windsor Castle next month. In the centre's cafe, William and Kate were given a briefing on the work of St. Luke's, which provides services and activities, has a range of facilities including a fully equipped cookery school, and runs community classes on healthy home cooking and avoiding food waste. The couple also took part in a recipe workshop and discussed favorite dishes and the inspiration behind them with the locals. William and his wife began their day at the Olympic Park's Copperbox Arena in Stratford, East London, for an event staged by Sports Aid, a national charity helping the next generation of Olympic, Paralympic and Commonwealth champions. Inside the 7,000-seat arena, which hosted handball and modern pentathlon fencing during the London 2012 Olympics, the royal couple met wheelchair basketball players led by television presenter Ada Depperton, who won bronze at the 2004 Paralympics in Athens. He encouraged William to have a go, and helped advise him on how to get the best performance out of the wheelchair, while Sports Aid's chief executive Tim Lawler told the Prince how difficult he had found the sport playing in a charity tournament for the past 3 years. "I've played for 3 years and only had one shot," Mr. Lawler said, adding that he had never scored. But William immediately impressed the players as he wheeled himself adeptly towards the basket, and came close twice before scoring, with his third attempt to the cheers of the watching crowd. "3 years, Tim," he said, smiling and taunting the chief executive. Robin Love, who competed in the sport at the Rio Paralympics in 2016, was impressed. "He was pretty good. Normally people can't reach the basket, or they try to jump out of the wheelchair when they shoot, but he was quite natural," she said. Upstairs on a balcony, the royal couple met double Olympic gold medalist Lizzie Arnold, who successfully defended her skeleton title at the Winter Games in Pyeongchang, South Korea, last month. She was helping to give media training to young athletes, and then joined Kate on a team of six competing in a quiz about the Commonwealth Games. There were about 20 teams, each named after a Commonwealth Games host city, and Kate's was Brisbane. Across from them, William joined Ada Depperton and four others on the Edmonton team. Quizmaster Clyde Muir, vice president of RBC Capital Markets at Royal Bank of Canada, one of Sports Aid's biggest financial supporters, asked five multiple choice questions about the history of the games. "Did you get that one?" "We got that," William shouted across at Kate, taunting her. His team got 4 out of 5, compared to 3 out of 5 for Kate's team, but another team won, getting all 5 right. On arrival this morning, the couple received a warm welcome from pupils from the Chobham Academy, who were bearing flags from Commonwealth nations, and paused to chat to them about their favorite subjects. William was overheard admitting to one youngster, who expressed a love of maths, "I hated maths at school. I was very bad at maths. I was good at geography. Do you find it easy? That's fantastic." Before they left, the couple were presented with gifts for their children, Prince George and Princess Charlotte. Athletes Vera Chindu and Amber Inning gave them a furry Gold Coast Commonwealth Games mascot each, Borobi, a blue koala. Despite being heavily pregnant with her third child, the Duchess' schedule has been busy over the past few weeks. Highlights have included attending her first official event with Meghan Markle, when the pair joined William and Prince Harry for a question and answer session about the Royal Trio's Royal Foundation and their charitable aims for the future. And on Wednesday, Kate launched a major project, an early years steering group, which will look at ways of improving how society supports children, so they have the resilience to cope with life's pressures when adults. The Duchess's due date has not been released, but it is thought that Cambridge's baby is expected a few days after the Queen's birthday, April 21, and well before Harry and Meghan's wedding on May 19.